So, as per the syllabus of appendicular skeleton of hip bones, we have completed almost all bones but one important bones which considered as the first bones of pelvic girdle, that is the first bone of the hind limb, also known as this pelvic girdle is known as hip bone and ox coccyx. So today we will discuss its normal configurations, architectures, along with musculature. What are the muscles? As we have already sent the on video of YouTube yesterday night. So now, what is pelvic girdle? What is pelvic girdle? So pelvic girdle, we can define, it is formed by the union of right and left hip bones. Therefore, the sacrum and first two or three coccygeal vertebrae. It depends upon the species. In some species, only two coccygeal vertebrae is responsible for to form all pelvic girdle, but in some up to the three. Pelvic girdle and hip ball generally formed by the union of three bones, ilium, ischium, and pubis. These three bones are from one side to other side, comes in contact to each other, and with the help of a symphysis, they form a girdle that is known as pelvic girdle. And this symphysis is called pelvic symphysis. Okay? So this symphysis is called pelvic symphysis, and pelvic symphysis contains two parts. Those towards the pubis bone that is known as pubic symphysis, and those towards the ischial bone that is known as ischial symphysis. So before starting in details, we have must an idea about their positions, because they all combine to each other. So you see the cursor. Cursor is visible, Moshmi?
Yes, sir.
So this, from here to here, this bone is known as ilium. This rounding position from here to here is known as ilium, both sides, because it is paired bone, both sides. This is the boundary of ilium. Again, from here, here to this one below the obturator foramen, this is known as ischium. This is known as ischium. And this obturator foramen, right and left side, and this bone from here, this is also a triangular bone from here to here, and this demarcation is pubic symphysis. This is known as pubic bone. So totally known as pelvic symphysis. From here to here is known as pelvic symphysis. And this part, where is the cursor standing, this is the pelvic floor. Here, anteriorly, is known as pubic symphysis, and this is ischial symphysis. Okay? So we have demarcated the area of the three bones. You see in this picture, this is the picture of my PhD thesis, one of the paper. So this is from here, M indicate, this M to up to the C, this is the ilium, and from I to K and J, this up to the this is known as ischium, and this is from B is the pubic symphysis, and K is the ischial symphysis. And from here to here, this is known as pubic bone. And this foramen is known as obturator foramen. And this is, on laterally, there is a cavity. This is known as acetabulum or cotyloid cavity. So I think you have cleared their demarcation or their boundary of the three bones. So what is ossicoccyx? Ossicoccyx is also known as hip bone, pelvic girdle. It consists of three flat bones. And these three flat bones are ilium, ischium, and pubis. Okay? They fuse to each other and forms a cavity. These three bones, ilium, ischium, and pubis, you see here, this is the ilium from here to here, and this is the ischium, and this part, this is the pubis. This comes in contact to each other and forms a cavity that is known as acetabulum or cotyloid cavity. So I think this is clear. What is cotyloid cavity or acetabulum? It is a cavity generally present in the pelvic girdle that is formed by the union of ilium, ischium, and pubis. If anybody asks to what is obturator foramen, the obturator foramen is the largest foramen of the body, which is present in the pelvic girdle, but found only by the involvement of ischium and pubis bone. See this picture. Ilium is from here to here, M. So there is no involvement of the ilium for the obturator foramen. So sometimes are always asked in the multiple choice or true, false, or objective question, fill in the blanks. The obturator foramen is formed by the union of three bones, ilium, ischium, and pubis. That is wrong. That is only formed by the pubis and ischium bone. Cotyloid cavity or acetabulum is formed by the union of pubis and ischium. That is false, because it is formed by the involvement of three bones. So see in this picture, this is the acetabulum, also known as cotyloid cavity, where the head of femur comes in contact with this, and with the help of round ligament, form a joint that is known as hip joint. So this is clear. This is from here to here is ilium. This is greater or superior sciatic span. We will discuss later on. This is the lesser.
Sir, आपकी आवाज काफी कट रही है.
Hello.
Yes sir, आवाज आ रही
है. मौसमी आवाज जा रही है.
Yes sir, हम लोग को आ रही है.
मनिका, ये तुम्हारा प्रॉब्लम है, क्योंकि बाकी लोग को तो जा रहा है. एनीऑन कोई और फेस कर रहा है? एनीऑन किसी और को प्रॉब्लम है क्या आवाज से? रिप्लाई करेगा कोई?
नो सर, आवाज आ रही है, क्लियर आ रही
है. हाँ, तो ये प्रॉब्लम तुम्हारा है मनिका. देखो नेटवर्क इशू है. अब जा रही है मनिका? मनिका
नो, मनिका आवाज जा रही है?
आवाज जा रही है मनिका?
यस यस सर, आ रही है.
ओके, सो अप टू दिस वी हैव क्लियर द देयर डिमार्केशन, एंड वी हैव एन आइडिया व्हाट इज ऑब्टुरेटर फोरामेन, व्हाट इज कोटिलॉइड कैविटीज, व्हाट इज एसिटाबुलम, एंड व्हाट इज सुपीरियर सिटिक स्पैन एंड लेसर सिटिक स्पैन, व्हाट इज ट्यूबर इश्चियाई, एंड व्हाट इज ट्यूबर कॉक्सी एंड ट्यूबर सैक्रल. दिस पार्ट फ्रॉम मीडियल पार्ट ऑफ दिस वन इज नोन एज ट्यूबर सैक्रल. This one is known as tuber sacral, because sacrum is in contact with this one. This is known as tuber coxi. Sometimes, fill in the blanks questions. External angle of ilium is known as, internal angle of ilium is known as, and trifid structure of the ischium is known as. So this is tubercular structure, tuber ischiae, tuber sacral, and this is tuber coxi, external angle. We will discuss later on. So these three bones comes in contact to each other and forms a joint that is known as hip joint. And the structures where the three bones comes in contact to each other and forms a cavity, this cavity is known as acetabulum or cotyloid cavity. So acetabulum is formed by the accommodation of head of femur with the help of round ligament. With the help of round ligament, which connect the hip bones, cotyloid cavity to the head of femur, and this joint is known as hip joint. So ilium extended up to this portion and forms a laterally located cavity that is known as acetabulum or cotyloid cavity. So this picture is clear. Again, the sentence is saying the pubis and ischium extended medially backward relatively on the medial border, fused to each other with the opposite bone, and as a whole this is known as pelvic symphysis or ischiopubic symphysis. This structure from here to here, where two bones, pubis and ischium, comes in contact with the opposite bones and forms this symphysis, is known as pubic ischial symphysis or ischiopubic symphysis or pelvic symphysis as a whole, because this forms the floor of the pelvic girdle. So it is known as pelvic symphysis. Okay, so this is known as pelvic symphysis or ischial symphysis, means involvement of pubic bone and the ischium bone, pubic symphysis and ischium symphysis. The pubic and ischium form the anterior and posterior part of the relatively of the floor of this pelvic girdle, and towards central and anteriorly some part forming a foramen that is known as obturator foramen. So what is obturator foramen? It is the largest foramen of the body, oval in shape. It depends upon the species. We will discuss later on in the what species is shape is round, oval, or elliptical in shape. So in case of the ox, this is the oval in shape, located between ischium and pubis. Ischium and pubis. Sometime in true false, obturator foramen formed by the union of ilium, ischium, and pubis. It is wrong. It is only formed by the union of ischium and pubis. In lifetime, it is closed. हमेशा के लिए बंद रहता है, लेकिन there is a minute opening in the center for the entry of in this obturator foramen. There is a minute opening at the G for the passage of entry of the blood vessel and nerve, which supply the nutrition to the structures present inside the pelvic cavity. So this is also a picture of this pelvic girdle. From here to here, this is the ilium, this is the ischium, this part is the ischium, and this is the pubis. From here to here, and this is the cotyledon cavity or acetabulum. We will discuss later on. We have an idea. So one by one. Now, what is ilium? Ilium is the longest or largest out of three. Ilium is the longest and largest out of three. And this is triangular bone. You see, this is the triangular bone. This is the triangular bone. And for description, it contains three surfaces. Some literature say two surfaces, but some say three surfaces. Three surfaces are what? One is the dorsal, or we can say lateral. Opposite to this one is medial surface. This one is the medial. And this is known as pubic surface. This surface, you see the cursor, because it comes in contact with the pubic bone, and also known as pelvic surface because it forms the pelvic cavity. So there are three surfaces. Lateral surface is also known as gluteal surface because gluteal muscles is attached here. This is the lateral surface behind this medial surface, and this is the pubic surface or the pelvic surface. So there are three surfaces in present inside the pubic bone, and it contains, for descriptions, this is known as wing from here to here, and this part from this one cotyledon cavity ever is known as sac. So there are two structures for description. It contains flat part of that is located in dorsal in position, that is the wing, and below that, that is the sac. And for the detailed description, it contains three surface, three border. This is the lateral border. You can say this is the lateral border, and this one is the dorsal border. This one is the dorsal border, and this one is the medial border. So three border is clear: dorsal border, lateral border, and medial border. Three angle. This is the internal angle. This is the external angle, and this is the distal angle. There are three angle. Internal angle is also known as tuber sacral, because sacrum comes in contact with here. This is known as tuber coxae, and this is known as distal angle. So we will discuss later here one by one. So this is a triangular bone, wide above and narrow below, prismatic in shape, triangular in shape, located craniolateral aspect of the pelvis. Aage ki taraf or lateral side mein. This bone's located craniolateral aspect of the pelvis, and upper part is wing and distal part is sac. We have discussed. And for description, it contains three surface, three border, and three angle. Three surface, three border, and three angle. So what are the surface? Outer surface, dorsal surface, or lateral surface, sorry, lateral surface is also known as gluteal surface, because it is for the attachment of gluteus medialis muscles. It is for the attachment of gluteus medialis muscle. And on this lateral aspect, there is a line that is known as gluteal line, which is for the gluteal medialis muscle. So lateral surface is also known as gluteal surface. That is a smooth, concave, dorso lateral in position, and backward passing on the standing position. When animal is the standing in positions, this look in backward in positions, and this surface having a line, we will see in the picture, this is known as gluteal line. This gluteal line is for the attachment of a muscle that is known as gluteus medialis muscle. This line runs downward and backward between the lateral border and sciatic spine. This surface serves as the origin of gluteus medialis muscle. We have already discussed, and the inferior third of this surface present a rough line that is known as gluteus profundus. That is known as gluteus profundus. So this sentence is saying about this one. This from here, this is known as gluteal line. You see here, this is known as gluteus line on its lateral aspect. This is for the attachment of gluteus medialis muscle, and below that, this line is for the attachment of gluteus profundus muscle. So lateral surface, only two important structure. One is gluteal line. This is for the gluteus medialis muscle. And below that, there is a another muscles comes here that is known as gluteus medialis profundus muscles. So this is gluteus profundus muscles. Okay. So next, lateral surface is completed. Next is the medial surface or the pelvic surface. Medial surface face towards the pelvic cavity, triangular in shape, and towards the medially, there is a rough triangular area, which is for the attachment of the sacral vertebra. We have already seen in this picture. On the lateral medial surface, there is a rough triangular area for the attachment of sacral vertebra. And laterally, this surface is covered by the iliacus muscles. Laterally, this surface is covered by the iliacus muscle. So you see this picture. In this picture, we have discussed regarding this one. There are this surface is known as lateral surface. We have completed lateral surface regarding to two structure, and this one is the medial surface. This medial surface from here to here, medially having a triangular area, some but triangular area for the attachment of tibial sacral, and this area from lateral side becomes flat and a smooth in comparison to this of the medial part of this surface. So we completed the one surface that was the lateral surface and the medial surface. Next one, right on the iliac surface, or we also describe as a pubic surface. This surface is directed forward and covered by the iliacus muscles, and there is a line that is known as iliopicial line, which separates these two surface, and it bears about on the middle having a tubercle. This is known as psoas tubercle for the attachment of psoas minor muscles. So two surfaces are clear, and this surface is known as iliac surface. This is because it comes towards the ilium bones here, and also known as the pelvic surface. This surface having a line that is known as iliopectineal line. This line known as iliopectineal lines. This one, and there is a tubercle both side. There is a tubercle. This tubercle is known as psoas tubercle, which is for the attachment of the psoas minor muscle. So we have completed the three surface, lateral surface. Only two important points. One is the gluteal line for the gluteal medialis muscles, and another for the gluteus profundus muscles. Medially, there is that this is a triangular area for the attachment of the sacrum, and laterally a smooth. This part is the smooth, and this completed the medial surface, and this is the ischial surface or the pubic surface here, in forming a line that is known as iliopischial line, and inside there is a tubercle. This tubercle is known as psoas tubercle, that is for the attachment of the psoas minor muscles. So I have completed the surface of the ilium bone, and now because we are going to describe three border and three angle. So dorsal border, we have seen in the picture, this is the dorsal border. We have described this is the dorsal border, somewhat concave and center, and both become tubercle. This is the dorsal surface, and this is the lateral surface, and this one is the medial surface. So this dorsal surface indicates the also known as this dorsal surface is also known as crest of ilium, that is thin, concave in center. We have already discussed concave in center, thick and rough towards both in for the attachment of muscles of loin. So muscle of loins attached on if the lateral part, that is called external angle of ilium, and this ilium is also known as tuber coxae, which is for the attachment of muscle of the loin. Lateral border or cotyloid border, because below that there is formation of cotyloid. This is the lateral border. Lateral border comes in, runs downward in directions and form a cavity that is known as cotyloid cavity. So this lateral border, also known as cotyloid border, and that is thin, runs downward and forms a cavity. This is for the origin of these muscles, that is the rectus femoris, and distally form the dorsal and lateral boundary of the acetabulum or cotyloid cavity. Medial border is also known as sciatic border, that is concave, runs downward and divided into two. Anterior one is known as pubic border, and which is forms the anterior border of the pubic, and posterior border is the greater sciatic notch or greater sciatic span, which is elevated and which give the attachment of the sacrosciatic ligament and gluteus profundus muscles. We have already discussed gluteo profundus muscles and the muscles, that is the sacrosciatic span, which is for the attachment of the sacrosciatic ligament. So what is sacrosciatic span and what is the gluteo profundus muscles, where he attached? You see here, this is the lateral border of the ischium. So this lateral border of ischium forms a concavity, becomes raised. This is known as superasciatic span or greater asciatic span. This is known as greater sciatic span, and this is known as lesser sciatic span. This is the part of the ischium. So up to this is known as a part of the ilium, which forms the acetabulum or the cotyloid cavity of the pelvic girdle. Okay, so up to this we have completed the surface as well as the border of the ilium bone. Next is the middle border. Okay, we have completed three borders, and there is a foramen near the greater sciatic spine that is covered by the sacrosciatic ligament, which is for the passage of gluteal nerve and the anterior gluteal iron vessels. This sentence is saying near the medial border or near the greater sciatic spines. This is the greater sciatic spine. You see, this is the greater sciatic spine. This is I is the greater sciatic. This there is a foramen. You see this foramen. This foramen is for the passage of the gluteal vessels, that is in form of nerve and artery. This sentence is saying about the passage for the passage of this foramen near the greater sciatic spines covered by the sacrosciatic ligament, and that is for the passage of gluteal nerve and the anterior gluteal vessels. So border is completed. There are three angles we have already discussed. Medial angle is known as tuber sacral because sacrum is comes in contact with these two bones of the opposite side, and this is also known as a point of crop. Lateral angle is also known as external angle of ilium or tubercoxis. This is 2 and 4 tubercles. Here the 2 and 4 tubercles comes in contact here. This is the 1, 2, 3. These tubercles comes in contact with each other and forms a voluminous part that is known as tubercoxis. This tubercoxis is for the attachment of the muscles that is known as iliacus, obliquus, abdominus, tensor fasciae lata, and gluteus medialis muscles. And later, the distal part that formed the shaft, this is known as acetabular angle. This one is known as acetabular angle, which comes in contact with the acetabulum and forms the acetabulum or cotyloid cavity. So we have completed the ilium bones up to this one. For description, three surface, three border, and three angle. Three angle, medial angle known as tubercicline, and lateral angle or external angle known as tubercoxis. This tubercoxis is for the attachment of this following muscle, and inferior angle is known as distal angle, which forms the acetabulum. Now, ischium. Ischium is the smaller than the ilium. We have already seen their demarcation, but quadrilateral in shape and placed behind the ilium and pubis, and it forms the floor of the pelvic girdle. For description, it has the two surface because the flat means two surface, and quadrilateral, four border and four angle. Four border and four angle. You see here, this is the dorsal surface, or we consider the pelvic surface. This is, and behind that, this is the ventral surface. Two surfaces clear. Four border. This is the anterior border. This is the anterior border. This is the lateral border. And this one from here to here. This from here to this direction. This is known as posterior border, and this is known as medial border. So I think four border are clear. This is the anterointernal angle. This angle is known as anterointernal angle, and this is the anteroexternal angle. Aage ki taraf aur bahar ki taraf, external angle. And this angle from here to here is known as piche ki taraf hai, positiro external angle. And this is known as positiro internal angle. Or this form the arc, this is known as ischella. So this sentence we'll discuss here. So there are two surfaces. One is the dorsal surface, is also known as the pelvic surface because it forms the part of the pelvic floor. Dorsal surface or pelvic surface is slightly concave, smooth, and forms the most of the part of the posterior part of the pelvic floor. And this is for the attachment of the obturator internus muscles and obturator externus muscles. So what is obturator externus and internus? Because this is the area for the dorsal surface of the ischium bone, and this area is covered by the obturator externus. Outer part of the obturator foramen is covered by the obturator externus, and internal part is formed by covered by a muscle that is known as obturator internus muscle. So obturator externus muscles comes in contact with the dorsal surface of the ischium of the pelvic girdle. Okay, so up to this is clear. Ventral surface present about the middle rough, there is for the attachment of a biceps mori muscles, and also for the orsin of the adductor muscles. There are two important muscles comes in contact with the ventral surface of the ischium bone. These muscles are biceps femoris and adductor muscles. So we completed the two surface of this ischium bone. Now a border. Anterior border we have already discussed. Anterior border is concave, thin, and forms the posterior boundary of the obturator foramen. This is the anterior border we have discussed. This is the anterior border of the ischium, which forms the posterior border of the obturator foramen. Next is the posterior border. Posterior border is thick, slow, forwarded, and comes downward in direction, meets to each other from the opposite side of the bones, and form a arc that is known as ischial arc. So this is the ischial arc. This is the posterior border. From here to here, this is the posterior border. So posterior border is thick in comparison to this one, and it comes in contact with the opposite bone of this and form an arc. This is known as ischial arc. What is anterior border? Anterior border forms the posterior boundary of the obturator foramen only, and is for the attachment of obturator externus muscle. This arc is the thick posterior border is thick and comes medially and comes in contact to the opposite bone of the ischium and form an arc that is known the ischial arc. So we completed there two border of the ischium, that is the anterior border or posterior border. And next is the medial border. Medial border we have already seen. When the two opposite bones come in contact to each other or form a symphysis, that's known as ischiatic symphysis or the ischial symphysis, which forms the floor of the pelvic girdle. And this symphysis play a major role for the provide the support the muscles, which is comes in contact with the male genital system. So with the help of suspensory ligament, with the help of suspensory ligament in case of the male, this ischial symphysis provide the attachment of this suspensory ligament which hold the penis in case of the male. And in case of the female, this suspensory ligaments, this structure means medial border of this structure forms a ligament that is known as suspensory ligaments, which holds the mammary glands. And ventrally, we check it up, there is a prominence that is known as ventral tubercle. We completed medial border, and lateral border is concave and forms a lesser sciatica span, because we have already seen that what is the greater sciatica span. Greater sciatica span is the part of ilium bone, and behind that the again concave part and become raised. This raised part is known as the lesser sciatica span. This is for the part of the ischium bones and becomes continuous, and this notch finally converted in the sciatica spines. And below that there is a lesser sciatic foramen, and this is for the lesser sciatic attachment of the lesser sciatic ligament and for the passage of the gluteal vessels or gluteal nerve in this part. So we completed the structure of this two surface, and four border has completed. Now angle, we have already seen aage ki taraf andar ki taraf antero internal angle or antero medial angle. This angle forms the posterior border of obturator foramen. We have already seen discussed in this when we have discussed about their border. So this angle located antero internal, aage ki taraf andar ki taraf, also known as antero medial, and it forms the posterior border of the obturator foramen and help in the formation of symphysis with the opposite one of the ischium. This symphysis is known as pelvic symphysis. So antero internal is clear. Opposite to that, this is the posterior internal. पीछे की तरफ और अंदर की तरफ, also known as posterior medial angle. This angle meet with each other and form an arc. We have already discussed when we discuss the border of this posterior border. This form an arc that is known as ischial arc. Now antero external, आगे की तरफ, बाहर की तरफ, lateral side में, also known as antero lateral angle. We join with the ilium and form the acetabulum or cotyloid cavity. Positiro external angle. This is the important structure of the objective point of view. Positiro external angle is expanded trifid process. Trifid process. This is also known as pin bone, and this pin bone is the site for origin of three muscles. These muscles are biceps.